Hello everyone. Welcome to Ortho Implants for Life. This week we will learn about femur interlocking nailing system.
Fixation procedure.
So let's begin.
We start with creating the entry point for the nail with the help of an awl, straight awl, curved awl, cannulated awl. It is totally upon surgeon's choice which awl he is going to use to create the entry point. Once our entry point is created, we will have to insert the beaded guide wire or the olive guide wire through the entry point. This guide wire helps in doing reduction and also guide all the instruments and implants in proper places and keep it aligned, like the nail, the reamer, and all the other instruments. After the entry point is created, we will have to insert this beaded guide wire or olive guide wire inside the canal. Now, in order to do that, we will have to use a T-handle chuck with key for us to hold the guide wire properly and push it. Once the T-handle is inserted in the guide wire, we will tighten the chuck and key. We will lock it and then use it to push the guide wire in. Once done, we remove the T-handle chuck. This is another piece of equipment, which is a guide wire holding forceps. This is used for holding the guide wire while reaming, so that when we are taking out the reamer, the guide wire does not come out with it. We press and hold the guide wire like this while taking out the reamer. Next, we will use cannulated solid hand reamer to rim through. As you can see, this is cannulated here and it is a solid hand reamer. Or we can use a cannulated flexible reamer. As you can see, this is flexible. We use a power drill to actually use this reamer. It is upon surgeon which reamer he is using or he will prefer to use. Next, we will do the reaming using either the solid hand reamer or the flexible one. Once reaming is done, we take out the reamer. Here you can see we are showing you with the flexible reamer as well. Reaming is done to create a smooth entry for the nail. Once the reaming is done, we will use a proximal reamer, which is of 13 mm, and do the reaming to create a proper entry point for the proximal part of the nail as well. Because as you can see here, the proximal part or the head region of the femur nail, it is having a bigger diameter, which is 13 mm, than the distal part. So to create a proper and smoother entry for this proximal part of the nail, we use a proximal reamer and rim at the entry point. Thereafter, we will use a medullary tube. We will insert the medullary tube through the help of the guide wire. Once inserted, we will check under the C arm that the medullary tube is properly inserted and the end of the guide wire is actually in proper place, and we'll check that the medullary tube has gone till the beaded end of the guide wire. Once done, we will actually remove the beaded or the olive guide wire and insert a plain or a normal guide wire through the medullary tube. Once the exchange has taken place, we will remove the medullary tube and the normal guide wire stays in. Next step, we will measure the length and the diameter of the nail required. Once the measurement is taken, we will connect the nail with the femur interlocking jig. We will take a conical bolt, insert it in the femur nail jig, and then connect the proximal end of the femur nail in the conical bolt, and then tighten this screw with free hand or with spanner. Now, in order to do the final tight, we can either use a box spanner or the 12-13 spanner. We can use any one of these to do the final tight. After this, we will first check the alignment of the nail before inserting the nail inside so that there are no complications that arises. In order to do that, we will insert a protection sleeve in this femur region, in these two holes. After protection sleeve, we will insert the 4mm drill sleeve and check with the 4mm drill bit if it is properly going through and there are no obstructions. We repeat the same process for the other hole as well. After the check, we will remove the protection sleeve and the drill sleeve and then insert the nail through the entry point with the help of the guide wire along with the jig. Once the nail is inside the canal, we will remove the guide wire thereafter from the proximal side of the nail. After this, we will first lock the distal end of the nail. We can either use a 4mm Steinman pin or a 4mm drill bit, any one of the two. Generally, this does depend upon the surgeon's preference and choice. We will directly drill through this hole. Then we take the measurement with the help of the depth gauge. Then we take a 4.5 mm solid screwdriver, 150 mm, the short one, and then take the 4.9 mm locking bolt of the measured length and lock the distal end of the nail. We repeat the same process for the other hole as well. If there is a gap within the fracture and we need to close the gap, we do a certain step before locking the proximal end. We are going to attach a slotted hammer unit in this region of the conical bolt. And then we take the extractor rod along with the hammering unit and then connect it with this slotted hammer unit. Once the distal lock is done for the femur nail, it will actually hold the nail in place while doing the back hammer. Once done, we will start doing the back hammering in order to close the gap in between the fracture. Once done, we will remove the entire slotted hammer unit along with the extractor rod and the hammering unit. Thereafter, we will lock the proximal end of the nail. We will first insert the protection sleeve. Then we use a trocar, insert it inside the protection sleeve to clear out any soft tissues getting stuck. Then we insert the 4mm drill sleeve inside the protection sleeve. Then we drill with the help of a 4mm drill bit. Now once the drilling is done for each of the holes, we will use the depth gauge to take the measurement for the jig We use 4.5 mm solid screwdriver, 200 mm, the long handle one. And with the help of it, we will fix the 4.9 mm locking bolt through the protection sleeve. We repeat the same process for the other hole as well. Thus, we complete the locking of the proximal end of the femur nail. This is how it will look. After this entire process, we will have to remove the jig from the nail. And in order to do that, we will use a box spanner in this case. Because when the nail is inside, it's actually hard to hold the spanner. So that is why we use a box spanner, because you can actually use it and operate from any angle. As you can see, you can perform either straight or you can actually use it from any of these angles. And then you just apply a little bit of force and it will open the conical bolt. Once we have removed the jig, we will either fix a 0mm or the 5mm end cap, depending upon the position of the nail. Then we will use a 4.5 mm solid screwdriver in order to fix the end cap. You can check the previous video to understand about the end cap. Link in the I button.
If you have enjoyed the video, like it, share it. If you are new to our channel, subscribe it. Hit the bell icon to get the notifications for our upcoming videos. If you have any queries, comment below and we will surely reply back. If you want to know more about career prospects in orthopedic implant industry and wish to start a career in orthopedic implant industry, please click the link below in the description box and DM us to know more. Thank you and see you in our next video.